काचित् कालिन्दि तट विपिन संगीत तरल मुदा नारी बदन कमला शाद मधुपह रमा शंभु ब्रह्मा मरुपति गणेशार्चित पद जगन्नाथ स्वामी नयन पथगामी भवतु मे।
हरे कृष्णा, टुडे इज द सेकेंड डे ऑफ श्री क्षेत्र जगन्नाथ पुरी परिक्रमा। वी आर गोइंग टू विजिट मेनी वंडरफुल प्लेसेस, इंद्रदुम्न सरोवर, नृसिंह टेम्पल, नरेंद्र सरोवर, Jagannath Vallabh Garden and so many other wonderful places. So be with me. And then so many great souls are going to speak about these places. So be with us. Let us all remember Lord Jagannath Swami and remember the great personalities and Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Nityananda Prabhu. Sri Khetra Jagannath Puri Pariparikrama 2020 Ki Jai.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare Bolo.
Hare Krishna,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. Krishna Krishna Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare
Hare Krishna. We are here in this beautiful and auspicious place of the birthplace of Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur Goswami Maharaj Srila Prabhupada. His father Bhaktivinoda Thakur, when he was there in Jagannath Puri as a magistrate, he requested Mother Bimala to give her, you know, give him a ray of Vishnu who will preach all over world the message of Sri Gauranga Mahaprabhu. And later part we know Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur appeared here in this very place. And in this place, Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur appeared. Rath Yatra time, 3 days the rath stopped. And then when Bhagavati Devi, his mother, taking little Bimala Prasad into her lap comes, the Jagannath's garland fell upon him and blessed him to become the 64 Gaudiya Math Pratishthata, the great personality who instructed Srila Prabhupada to establish, you know, beautiful Hare Krishna movement, and went, you know, he asked also to go to the Western country and talk and preach about Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's message. Then he came and he preached throughout the world the message of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. It started here. This is the birthplace, you can say, of the whole Gaudiya mission, which spreaded the whole world. And because of him and Srila Prabhupada, we are here doing the parikrama. Let us all pray here to the Acharya's birthplace and seek the blessing of the Acharya. Hare Krishna, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur Goswami Srila Prabhupada Ke Jai.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna.
Hare Krishna,
Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna. गुंडीचा महारानी की गुंडीचा मंदिर की दिस इज द प्लेस वेयर लॉर्ड जगन्नाथ कम्स एंड स्टेज 7 days. इट इज वृंदावन नॉन डिफरेंट फ्रॉम वृंदावन इन द मूड ऑफ अ कावर्ड बॉय कृष्णा कम्स हियर एवरी ईयर इन द रथ यात्रा एंड स्टेज हियर 7 days. एंड दिस इज द प्लेस वेयर श्री चैतन्य महाप्रभु क्लीन गुंडीचा टेम्पल दैट इज कॉल्ड गुंडीचा मार्जनम. हाउएवर गुंडीचा महारानी name has been given here because the Lord said you are my mother and Indradumna Maharaj is my father and I will be always there with you. Regarding this also there are a lot of pastimes. You need to read Bhakti Purushottam Maharaj book, maybe it will be very easier for you to understand. However, we will pray here whole year. It is closed only Rath Yatra time. 7 days the Lord stays here and he is in the mood of Shri Vrindavan Dham. So we are here, we are praying that we all can get the mercy of Gundicha Maharani, Indradumna Maharaj, Shri Vrindavan Dham. And this darshan of Gundicha is called Adapa Darshan. 10 years taking darshan in the Sri Mandir and one time darshan, once darshan here is equivalent. So it's very auspicious. Let us all pray to Lord Jagannath that one day he can all give us darshan in Gundicha.
We are very fortunate to be in this wonderful place, Gundicha. Shri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, very early in the morning, he took all his devotees together and they all went to Gundicha to meet the secretary of Prataprudra Maharaj. So, The manager said the king had already given me order that whatever you need should be given. Anything. So Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu decorated all the devotees very nicely and everybody was engaged in cleaning the temple. Well, a temple is a building, structure, with so many things inside. A temple also represents the heart, because that is where Lord Krishna stays. Krishna stays in the temple, and the heart is where Krishna stays, which is the temple. So the Gundicha Marjana is actually our own personal life as a devotee. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu taught us how to practice Krishna consciousness by engaging every devotee. Every devotee was engaged in carefully cleaning the ceilings, cleaning the walls, cleaning the ground, sweeping and send every dust outside. So Marjana means cleaning our own heart, not just the building. Of course, the physical building was there, but Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was teaching us how to practice Krishna consciousness. So every devotee was collecting grains of sand. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was supervising everyone. This is what this is the duty of a spiritual master, to see all the devotees, everyone, how we are practicing Krishna consciousness. Chastise, he push, drag us, push. See, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was teaching us this, how to be a guru, how to be a disciple, how to practice Krishna consciousness. And when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu will see that one is making advancement, how does he do that? By looking at devotees who are collecting more dust. Who is collecting more? This is, who is making more advancement? Is collecting more dust. In the same place, everybody is cleaning. Not that he selected people here and there. We are free to practice Krishna consciousness. But who is practicing the most? The Chaitanya Mahaprabhu will go to him. And they were cleaning, washing. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu personally saw that every dirt that was collected were all thrown outside. Very far. very far so that they didn't come here, back inside. So first it was dusting, wiping everything from the ceilings down to the floor, then sweeping also, then washing. Washing. You know, when you are washing, it's not so easy. When I'm washing, when I'm cleaning and washing, it's not so easy. Or you notice when you are serving prasadam for many people, how do you feel? Waist pain. So you like you to retire on time to go and sit and so you'll be served. It's easier to be served than to serve. So when we are getting purification, it is not easy. It is painful. Just like when the child is learning how to walk. It's not easy. You fall and have some bruises on your feet. Cry, oh, everybody come, oh, sorry. That also is going on in our Krishna conscious life. As we are growing, as we are making advancement, a lot of mistakes, a lot of chastisement, the pain of growing is always there with devotees. And many of us are not so fortunate, so to say. We're not so fortunate that the pain of growth is like intolerable. How can I tolerate this pain? But that is what you make you strong. That way will make you strong, because as you are walking and falling, pain, you become strong. When you continue like that, you become very strong and strong and strong and stronger. That you become immovable. So Gundija temple was clean inside and also outside. Means what? Inside is clean and outside is also clean. You can look at it in different ways. One way is we clean our body outside, we clean our body inside. By chanting holy name and by taking regular bathing and washing, keeping our clothes very clean. So we are washing inside and we are also washing outside. Chitamu taught that. Clean inside. He did not just throw it there like that. No, he threw it very far away. So there is no chance of it, any dust coming back inside. So there is a fence. We have to put a fence. The fence is to study the scripture very carefully so that we know how to avoid all the necessary offenses. And even the offenses which we make unintentionally due to weakness, we learn from it and make advancement. Chitambu taught this process to every devotee, and every devotee was learning. So that is Gundicha that we are hearing. It's this day, physically day in Jagannath Puri. And the Gundicha, it is also individual. As we are practicing our Krishna consciousness, our Gundicha is our own self. So we are cleaning outside, Gundicha. So the Gundicha temple was cleaned inside and outside. Devotees were very happy. You know, when you take a fresh bath, how you look like? You look nice, you look vibrant, you look sweet, you happy. Then Jagannath Ratha Yatra, Chitambapu dance with devotees, form parties behind, you form parties within the chariot and friend party in the front. Heavy kirtan. Chitambapu were dancing in all the parties. And he selected those who play mridanga, those who play the karatlas, those who will sing, those who will dance. Hare Krishna. Chitambapu taught all this process. He personally selected Haridas, Bakreshwara Pandita, Nityananda Prabhu, Advaita Acharya, and he gave them all the associates who play mridanga the taste you want. In this way, the kirtan was going on. When Chitambapu would dance, Lord Balaram, Lord Jagannath would stop to enjoy the kirtan. Until Lord Jagannath is satisfied, the chariot will not move. So there was a constant competition between Daru Brahma and Gora Hari. When they go to Guntachi Temple, Chittamahapu were remembering his life as Srimati Radharani and Krishna. And he was speaking about that. He was speaking about to his confidential devotees about their life in Vrindavan. Vrindavan is a special place. Srimati Radharani is expressing how she doesn't feel happy in the association of horses, elephants, chariots, weapons. Srimati Radharani said this is too noisy, so that one can enjoy that. So Chittamahapu was expressing this among his devotees. As he entered into Gunchicha, he was speaking about all these persons, Radha and Krishna, what his devotees, so sweet. This is how Chittamahapu, with all his devotees celebrating Jagannath Ratha Yatra, entered into Jagannath Puri, and they continue like this. We are so fortunate to be here in this Puri Yatra, experiencing the bliss of Jagannath, who is Krishna, Chittamahaprabhu, who is Radharani. Hare Krishna.
Hare, Hare, Hare Krishna.
हरे कृष्णा श्रीक्षेत्र जगन्नाथ पुरी परिक्रमा की जाए। परमानंदपुरी सचेतन महाप्रभुज गुरुवर्ग, ही वॉज द गॉड ब्रदर ऑफ ईश्वरपुरी, वॉज बीन इन द सेम लिनियज, सेम परंपरा कमिंग फ्रॉम माधवेंद्रपुरी। चैतन्य महाप्रभु यूज टू लव हिम, एंड व्हेन चैतन्य महाप्रभु केम हियर टू जगन्नाथपुरी, ही ऑल्सो केम एंड स्टेड विथ हिम। ही मेड अ वेल, बट इन दैट वेल द वाटर वॉज नॉट सो स्वीट, and he was very unhappy that for the pilgrimage, you know, I made this well, but this water is so dirty, which lot of dirt is there. And at that time, what happened actually, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu heard, and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, Paramananda Prabhu, you are the devotee of Lord Jagannath. I will request Lord Jagannath to send Mother Ganga here from his lotus feet. And then within one night, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came next day and took bath here and drank water. And he exclaimed that now Bhagavati Ganga is flowing here, and anyone little bit of water he takes, he will be getting the benefit of drinking Ganga water, and he will get instant Krishna prem. So we are here in the same place, and we are worshipping this place. Let us all remember the Paramananda Puri and his well, which is instantly giving Krishna prem. The well. Hare Krishna. So we are standing in front of this beautiful deity. This is not Hanuman, this is Sugriv. In Jagannath Puri, there are so many Hanuman temples. People feel that it are Hanuman, but actually they are Jambuban, Angad, and so many other great personalities from Ramayana. So he is Sugreev. This is Jagannath Vallabh Garden, and we will be very soon describing the whole pastimes here, what has happened. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is to visit here. So many pastimes are connected to this time, you know, this place which has been established by Ramananda Roy. But before that, please take blessing of Sugreev and Jai Shri Ram. Hare Krishna. So we are here at the divine lotus feet of Sugreev, and with the blessing of Guru Gauranga and Srila Prabhupada, we are having this wonderful Tirtha Yatra, and we have one of our god brother here, His Holiness Bhakti Vijay Bhagavat Maharaj, who is leading the Bengali Yatra, Bengali Sri Khetra Parikrama. So very happy to be getting his association here, and he will be speaking in Bengali for the Bengali crowd. And I will just brief you, because all the time whenever we come here, we sit down here and we hear from Bhakti Purushottam Swami Maharaj, sometimes, you know, Bhakti, you know, Ashray Bhagavat Maharaj and all of them. However, this year is a different year, so we are all hearing definitely from different personalities. So here is a very unique place. This place is called Jagannath Vallabh Udyan, which been established by Ramananda Roy. Ramananda being the, Ramananda Roy being the minister of, South Indian minister of Pratapindra Maharaj, and Pratapindra Maharaj, you know, was very happy with him. He was a Vaishnav, and he established a temple here. His Jagannath deities are there, and his Sadabhuj Mahaprabhu, Sadabhuj Krishna is there. And fortunately, we cannot go inside. There is nothing called, you know, unfortunate in Krishna consciousness. And we offered our prayers there. This place is very significant because all the Gaudiya Vaishnavas, they will come here walking from Bengal, and many times near, just nearest to this place is Narendra Sarovar, and right side is the Jagannath Sri Temple, Sri Mandir. So this is also the Milanasthali, you know, where the Bengali and the Odia and all devotees around India, around, you know, this place will come under the lotus feet of Sri Gauranga Mahaprabhu and Nityananda Prabhu, and they will meet here. So this place is very, very significant for all of us, because as Srila Prabhupada made whole world chant the holy name, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. It all began here by the mercy of Sri Sri Gaur and Nitai Chandra. Then this place is also very significant because from here the fruit and flowers and the roots, everything goes for the Jagannath service. Jagannath Vallabh Garden, Jagannath Vallabh Udyan, this whole place maintains also many parts of Jagannath services in the temple inside. This is the place Ramananda Rai used to train his small, Devdasis, who used to dance for the pleasure of Lord Jagannath. And many times Chaitanya Mahaprabhu will come here and they will recite and he will discuss Krishna Katha, especially from Srimad Bhagavatam, that also here. This is also the place where Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, in one Purnima, in a full moon night, underneath the Ashoka tree, saw Sri Krishna, and then he was chasing him. This is also the place where the Benta Yatra, you know, the fighting Yatra, and the Shikar, you know, what do you call that? Hunting also takes place. Then Krishna and Balaram also steals the Damanak, you know, what do you call, plant here. They have, and there is a, what do you call, a karagar, a jail also, where Krishna Balaram is put there. That also happens here. And every year, many other festivals takes place in Jagannath Vallabh Garden. This is our great fortune that we are touching this ground and we are taking the blessings. So, thank you very much. Sri Sri Jagannath Vallabh Udyan Ki Jai. Jai Ramananda Rai Ki Jai. Gaur Premanande Hari Hari Bol. And also, Bhakti Ashray Vaishnav Maharaj will be speaking in detail about this place to all of you. I have given just a synopsis of this place. Hare Krishna. Be with us. Hare Krishna. Thank you, Maharaj, for being with us. Hare Krishna.
Thank you.
Hare Krishna.
So today we are in Sri Jagannath Vallabh Garden. Sri Jagannath Vallabh Garden is one of the old garden and dearmost garden of Sri Jagannath. Vallabha, the meaning of word Vallabha is priya, dear. So Jagannath likes this garden too much. For Gaudias, this Jagannath Vallabha garden is famous because Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu performed some glorious pastimes there. One of them is Pratap Rudra Uddhar. When Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was there in Puri, almost 520 years before, at that time the Gajapati Maharaj was Pratap Rudra Dev. So Pratap Rudra Dev, when he heard that the Sarabhauma Pandit, the eminent scholar of that era, he got totally changed, transformed. His thinking, feeling, talking, everything changed when he, within a week, by coming in contact of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And everybody asked, what happened, Sarvam Panditji? Sarvam Pandit told, this is all because of his Parambrahma Parameshwar. Who? That is new sannyasi. What? You are considering a man as a Supreme Lord? Yes, yes, yes. So Sarvam Panditji, very serious, very learned scholar. So when he is saying, not only saying, it totally transformed. So all the scholars of Orissa, all over Orissa, including the king, they get really astonished, and they all want to see if Sarvam Pandit is considering this person as Supreme Lord, then we have to see. Everybody want to see. But Mahaprabhu, he left for South India. Anyway, when he come back, even Sri Pratap Rudra Dev, the king, he want to visit him, but Mahaprabhu denied, no, 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 I can't see the king. So king tried and tried and tried, but Mahaprabhu was denying. But finally, all these senior devotees, they made a plot, and they requested king that when Mahaprabhu in Rath Jatra's time, in front of Rath Jatra, when he will dance and become tired, he used to go and take rest in this garden. So during that time, you change your dress in a civil dress. O king, you should go to this garden and do service. What service? Not started massaging his feet. And while you massage his feet, Ramananda Raya suggested that you chant this chapter of Bhagavatam, Gopika Git. So King Pratap Rudra memorized that chapter of Ras Panchadhyayi. And then, yes, Mahaprabhu also get tired after dancing in Ratha Jatra day. And he went to the park, the Jagannath Vallabha Udyan, and he took rest there. So, and according to the agreement, King Pratap Rudra, wearing a civil dress, he went silently and slowly started massaging Mahaprabhu's feet and started chanting these verses. Starting from verse number 1, he was chanting without any music and something like that. So when he was chanting the 9th verse, Tava kathamritam tapta jeevanam kavi bhiriditam kalma sapaham savana mangalam simadatatam bhuvi grunantite bhuridajana. Simon Mahaprabhu wake up and shout bhuridajana, 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 and embrace King Pratap Rudra, and rolling in the ground, severing, all his hair stand in end, profusely tears are coming down from his eyes and shouting Bhuridajana, Bhuridajana, and rolling in ground, both of them. Both of them are prema vikara. So everybody, all the devotees, they chant Hari Bol, Hari Bol, because this Prataprudra, he never expect that Mahaprabhu will give darshan to me. Many, many trial he has tried. It was not happening. And all the devotees also, they said, how come it will happen? But just by the effect of this Gopika Gitam and this menial service, Mahaprabhu became so happy, so attracted, that not only darshan, sparshan, alingan, everything. So, and he asked after a long time, when he come to his consciousness, external consciousness, and he asked, who are you? Then Prataprudra Dev told, I am just a menial servant of your servant, of servant, of servant. Anyway, Mahaprabhu is Sarvantar Jami. He could understand. So Prataprudra's deliverance of Prataprudra, Prataprudra Udhar Lila, it's happened in this particular garden. And Ramananda Raya came, and while he was staying in Puri, this is his residence place, Jagannath Vallabh Mutt. He used to stay there. Now in this Jagannath Vallabh garden, the Jagannath Vallabh Mutt is there. There is a saying that this mutt belonged to some Vishnu Swami Sampradaya. It is said that the Kulaguru of Ramananda Raya family, they belong to Vishnu Swami Sampradaya. So that's why they built this mutt. Very old mutt. Because Ramananda Raya was staying there, and he is very, very, very highly elevated poet and drama writer and very, very highly elevated devotee. So he used to train the Devadasis for the pleasure of Jagannath to perform the drama of Jagannath Vallabha Natakam. So he used to do these things in this garden also. Because it was a dense garden, many ways in nice groves where they are, totally solitary place. So that's a very nice. So there only Ramananda Raya used to stay and do this real self program for drama. Also, when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu used to stay there, each year in Rasa Yatra time, he used to spend almost 9 days, the whole Rasa Yatra time, he will stay there only. He will not come back to Gambhira. Navadina Yatra, Mahaprabhu used to stay with all his associates there in Jagannath Vallabh Garden. So in this way, this Jagannath Vallabh Garden is full of many, many pastimes of Sri Jagannath and Sivan Mahaprabhu and all other devotees. Even Sivan Mahaprabhu was feeling separation from Krishna and looking Krishna and searching for Krishna there in this garden. So many, many pastimes happening in this Jagannath Vallabh Garden. So today we are there in Jagannath Vallabh Garden, so we can discuss this, and we can see from here Narendra Sarovar and Sri Jagannath Nila Chakra. This is one of the very, very dearmost place of Lord, even Jagannath and Gauranga Mahaprabhu. So, Sri Jagannath Vallabh Garden ki samvet bhakta vrinda ki.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Rama, Rama.
Hari Hari. So we are here in Adi Nishinga temple, and Adi Nishinga temple is the first temple in Jagannath Puri. Before installing the deities, before installing the beautiful temple, Indradumna Maharaj did a big yagya. And after that yagya, from the Yavankunda appears a very fearsome personality to bless him, and that is Lord Nrisimhadev. However, he was very frightened and he said that, "My dear Lord, I need to see you in a very cooler form. You know, everybody wants cool person." And that's why Lord Nrisimhadev appeared in a very Shanta Murti, in a Yoga Nidra Murti. And in that form, the Lord has been worshipped here. Here is a place where we are coming in our parikrama to seek blessing of Lord Nrisimhadev, that our parikrama and all the devotees around the world be always, you know, protected by the Sudarshan, by Lord Nrisimhadev, and we can do our devotional service, we can chant the holy name, and we can do parikrama, and let Nrisimhadev destroy all the negativity of this world, that the whole world can all come to Jagannath Puri and take his blessing. Sri Jagannath Swami Ki Jai.
Hare Krishna. We are here at Adi Narasingha temple. This is also known as Yajna Narasingha temple. This temple is located next to Gundicha temple, towards southeast side. This is very interesting place. This is believed that this deity was brought by Narad Muni. Narad Muni accompanied Indradumna king on the way to Puri. 4 days before he left, he said, "After 4 days I will come." So after 4 days, when Narad Muni came, he came with this king set of the time. He came with this deity of Nrisimhadev, and this Nrisimhadev temple was built by that time in Satyajug was built by Vishwakarmaji. So thus this temple is very important temple. And Mahaprabhu, after doing this Gundicha Marjana, he went and he did Marjana for this Narasingha temple also, and lot of chanting and dancing took place there, and very beautiful Narasingha deity. And the front side is Santa Narasingha, and back side there is Ugra Narasingha. Usually pujari, they don't allow to take darshan of Ugra Narasingha, but if Vaishnavs they go and give some dakshina, then they allow on the back side the Ugra Narasingha, or the front side is Santa Narasingha. It is believed, or not, Shastra says that when Indradumna king, he had this yajna, Dharma Yajna, Narasingha Bhagavan appeared very Ugra form. Then he took form of Santa Narasingha. That's why this place is called as Narasingha Khetra. Puri is called as Narasingha Khetra. Jai Adi Narasingha, Yajna Narasingha Bhagavan Ki Jai. Hari Bol.
Hare Krishna, Jagannath, Parikrama Ki Jai Ho. So Mahaprabhu says Sadhu Sangha, Nam Kirtan, Bhagavata Shravan, Mathuravas, Srimurti, Shraddhai Sevan. All these five aspects of devotional service is fully happening now. We are in Dham, we are worshipping the Lord in His deity form, we are hearing from different Swamis and Goswamis and Dasas and so many great souls, and we are associating with devotees, we are walking together, and then we are in Jagannath Puri. So let's stay back. Let this yatra goes, and we be happy, isn't it? So now where I am, can you guess? Yes, those who comes every year must be understanding this great place. This is the place of Markandeshwar Mahadev temple. You can see the temple. This is the great Vaishnava who always chants Ram Rameti Rameti Rame Rame Manorame Sahasranama Tatulyam Rama Nama Varanane. Always is chanting Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram Hare Ram 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 Hare Hare. And this is the place where Markandeya Muni, he is powerful. He chanted and requested Mahadev to give him a big long life. Later part, he was quite sad about it. Why? Because in Pralaya, he was the only person who was swimming. And he is the only person who saw in a banyan tree leaf, beautiful Krishna, you know, lying and, you know, he is floating. Bas, itna tak, this much only. Because His Holiness Bhakti Purushottam Swami Maharaj is going to speak about this place and the five Mahadevas of Jagannath Puri. Let's take darshan, means from our mind, because camera cannot go inside, and we will be praying for you all. This is one of the five Mahadevas, and this is the kunda that you can see. We will take darshan of the kunda as well. Stay with us. We are in Jagannath Puri. We are enjoying with Lord Jagannath. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.
So Markandeya Hare Krishna. So now here we will discuss about Markandeshwar Mahadev. Out of Panchashiva, Markandeshwar Mahadev is one of the out of Panchashivas. And this Markandeshwar Mahadev is Arjun. Pancha Pandav is Arjun, known as Arjun. And Markandeshwar Mahadev is in one corner of Jagannath Puri. Towards west and north corner. Actually, Markandeya Sarovar, there is a pond called Markandeya Sarovar. On the bank of Markandeya Sarovar, this Markandeshwar Mahadev is there. And Shastra says this is the most ancient Tirtha in Jagannath Puri. And there is Markandeshwar Mahadev is there, Linga is there. Very interesting pastime. So there is Markandeya Rishi. Markandeya Rishi is the son of Mrikanda. His name is Markandeya. So he was destined to die when he is 8 years old. So he was a worshipper of Shiva. So when the day he entered into 8th year, then he was worshipping a Shiva Linga at that time. Then Yamaraj came to take him. So when he see Yamaraj, he got very scared. He got so scared. So he grabbed Shiva Linga, requesting Lord Shiva, please protect me. And he grabbed the Shiva Linga so heavily, tightly, that the Linga cracked into pieces. Interestingly, if you go now, still you will see that Linga is not the whole form. It's like you can see the one stone or Linga has cracked apart. Like that, you can see that also. And Lord Shiva came out of that and told Yamaraj, stop, you can't take him. He is not going to die, he is my devotee. On 8 years old, he supposed to, he said, no, he will live for seven kalpa. He will survive for seven kalpa. Seven kalpa means 7 days of Brahma. Satya, Tatya, Dwapar, Kali, like this. There are 1,000 times in 1 day of Brahma. And this Markandeya Rishi was blessed to survive for seven kalpa. But end of every kalpa there is annihilation. Everybody die. The whole planet becomes inundated with water, the poor Markandeya Rishi cannot die because he is blessed not to die, but he can't, there is no place to survive also. He would be drowning, tossing around, suffering like anything. Finally came to Puri. In Puri there is Aksha but Kalpavata on Jagannath temple. So there he went and Lakshmi Narayan met Lakshmi Narayan. Then Lakshmi Narayan told, you go on top of this tree and on the leaf you will see the Bal Mukunda form. Then Markandeya went top of the tree and saw on the banyan leaf Bal Mukunda Bhagavan, baby form Bhagavan is there. He was sucking his toe up his leg, sucking that. Then when Markandeya went, the Bal Mukunda form, he opened his eyes. Then Markandeya entered the stomach. And there he saw unlimited Brahmandas are there. So Markandeya started to walk to see how big the belly of the small baby. Walking, he could never reach the end. Finally, through his throat he came out. Then he told Lakshmi Narayan, I'll stay here, please give me some place. Then Lakshmi Narayan gave the place to Markandeya Rishi, the bank of Markandeya Sarovar, where this Markandeshwar Mahadev is there. So that is the story behind Markandeya Sarovar, Markandeshwar Mahadev. Markandeshwar Mahadev is Arjun. He's known as Arjun. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Krishna is Rasaraj. Krishna enjoys all beautiful pastimes. Krishna's name is Rasik Rai. He is very, very, what do you call, a person who enjoys his devotees, enjoys food, enjoys rides. And that's why the scripture says, Dole cha dola govinda chape cha madhusudana rathe cha bhamana drishta punarjanmana vidyate. He also engages his devotees in his transcendental services. In the palanquin when he comes, as Govinda, Chapecha Madhusudana, in the boat, when he sees, he rides on the boat. And also when he is in Jagannath temple and comes out in the rath, if one person sees once time only, he will be never take birth again in this material world. So that is the reason we are here, where the boat pastime of Lord Jagannath takes place. 42 days, the whole festival of Chandani Yatra, which starts from Akshaya Tritiya, and then 21 days here and 21 days inside the temple, the Lord had water pastime. This is the place where the Lord, comes in a boat. First he comes in palanquin and then in the boat, and then he rides, and there are bathtubs, he is inside, and he does a lot of beautiful pastimes here. This is called Narendra Sarovar, Narendra Pukur or Chandan Pukur, because Chandan Yatra takes place here. During Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's time, the beautiful deity of Radha Madan Mohan used to come here, and Mahaprabhu personally will come here and bathe the Lord, pull the rod, push the rod, the Lord when he is in the boat. And then sometimes Mahaprabhu will swim here and he will sprinkle water in the, in the other devotee's head. Sometimes the Gaudiya Vaishnavas will meet here in Chaitanya Mahaprabhu when he is doing this water pastime. And after the all Gaudiyas and Odia devotees of the Lord meet together, after the festival they will all go to the Jagannath temple for getting darshan of Lord Jagannath Swami. This is one of the tirthas of Jagannath Puri, which is called, Chandan Pukur, as I said, on Narendra Sarovar. Let us all sprinkle some water and get blessed. Hare Krishna. And for you all, Haribol.
नव गौरवरं नव पुष्पसरं नव भावधरं नवलाशपरं नव हास्यकरं नव हेमवरं प्रणमामि सचिसुत गौरवरं प्रणमामि सचिसुत गौरवरं प्रणमामि सचिसुत गौरवरं नव हेमजुतं नव नीतसुचं नव वेशकृतं नव प्रेमरसं नव धाविलासं शुभ प्रेममयं प्रणमामि सचिसुत गौरवरं प्रणमामि सचिसुत गौरवरं प्रणमामि सचिसुत गौरवरं हरिभक्ति परं हरि नाम धरं करो जप्यकरं हरि नाम परं नयनेश ततः
हरे कृष्णा सर्वभूताचार्य उद्धार की सो महाप्रभु गॉट अनदर नेम सर्वभौम तोषण सर्वभौम तोषण मीन्स हु डिलीवर्ड एंड पैसिफाइड सर्वभूताचार्य I know, you can guess where we are. We are sitting at the lotus feet of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Sarvam Bhattacharya in Sarvam Bhattacharya's very house, which is actually more than 500 and plus years. Every year we come here and different sannyasis and maharajas and Prabhupada disciples speak. Here we are offering you this beautiful dham, this beautiful place. Where Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, after taking darshan first time in Jagannath Puri, after taking sannyas, he was unconscious and in a palanquin he was brought by Sarva Bhattacharya here into this place. And here he stays more than 2 months. And here there are so many wonderful pastimes that took place. And the first and foremost thing that took place is Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu delivered him 7 days continuously. You know, he heard and then at last Sarva Bhattacharya understood he is Krishna, he is Rama and he is Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself. About this whole episode, I am not going to tell whom you can guess is the best person to speak about this place and specifically about Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in Puri in from Chaitanya Charitamrita. Any guess? I understood. You all understand who is the best person to speak on is His Holiness Srila Jayapadaka Swami Guru Maharaj. He is going to speak about this, so I am not touching that. Now, Amogha's deliverance and everything also happened here. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came here and for 7 days continuously, he took prasad here. Sarva Bhattacharya, understanding him, Krishna himself, he surrendered to him. And later part, he invited Mahaprabhu for maybe 2 months and Mahaprabhu said, no, it is 1 month. And he said, no 1 month, it is 15 days, no 15 days, it is 10 days. And later part, 7 days, no 7 days, 3 days. Like this, there was a loving, you know, affair was going between Sarva Bhattacharya and Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Detail, if you want, definitely you can hear Chaitanya Charitamrita from different wonderful personalities and wonderful souls. And definitely, Srila Prabhupada also gives elaborate descriptions about this in his Bhaktivedanta Purports in Chaitanya Charitamrita. So, here is also the place where a great personality, who was Sachi Devi in his Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's in parampara. She established this place after Sarva Bhattacharya went back to the spiritual world. A later part, this place was called Ganga Mata Goswamini Mutt, who is actually one of our great Vaishnavi, who was very dare and very powerful personality in Srimad Bhagavatam. Even at that time, the Purushottam Dev, the king, also took initiation from Ganga Mata Goswamini. So let us all pray here, to Sarva Bhattacharya and his deities, Radha Rasik Shekhar, and so many other great personalities who served this temple. There is also a tunnel which Sarva Bhattacharya used to use to go to the temple, which we are not taking you all because we cannot go inside as well. You need transcendental body now to go there, which we await for. Okay, so let us all try now to absorb this place, and let us all hear from His Holiness Śrīla Jayavardhaka Swami Guru Maharaj about this place, and let's pray to Sarva Bhattacharya that all the misconception is gone from his heart by the mercy of the devotional service that by personally taught by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Hare Krishna.
Hare Haraya Namaha. Lala Raya Namaha.
Hari Haraya Nama Krishna Yadavaya Nama Hari.
Gopala Govinda Ram Srimada Sudan.
Gopala Govinda Ram Srimada Sudan.
Makakara Divajalam. Mangulangai Tegurim. Katisahata Rahanmane. Sigurim Dinsayam. Paramananda Madhavam. Sri Chaitanya Ishram.
Hari Om.
So today, we're here in Sri Khatra, Janapuri, Parikrama.
So today, we are here in the Sri Kshetra Jagannath Puri Parikrama.
Here, Lord Chaitanya spent 18 years of the latter part of his pastimes on earth.
So here Lord Chaitanya passed 18 years on the later part of his pastimes.
Now this is a very important place for Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's pastimes.
So this is a very important place for Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's pastime.
The Lord Nityananda breaking his danda, Lord Chaitanya came to the Jagannath temple alone.
So, due to Lord Nityananda breaking Lord Chaitanya's danda, so the Lord came to Jagannath Puri temple alone.
And left his associates behind him. When he entered the temple of the Jagannath Baladevan, Subhadra.
When he entered the temple of Jagannath Baladev and Subhadra and Sudarshana Chakra,
he felt such ecstasy that he fell unconscious on the ground.
Before the deity.
So the Pujaris thought, who is this crazy fellow that brought the throne out?
So the Pujari saw, who is this crazy fellow that?
They are about to throw him out. But Sarva Bhattacharya, he noticed that the Lord had unusual qualities.
But Sarva Bhattacharya, he noticed that the Lord had unusual qualities.
Since he was the head pundit, and Jagannath Puri, he ordered them to carry Lord Chaitanya to his house.
Since he was the head pandit of Jagannath Puri, he ordered them to carry Lord Chaitanya to his house. There Lord Chaitanya was lied down.
And it seemed that he was dead.
Seemed that he was dead.
He, It seemed that he was not breathing or no heartbeat.
So it was seemed that he was not breathing, there was no heartbeat.
And then Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya held a cotton swab by his nostrils.
But Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya held a cotton swab by his nostrils.
Saw that there was a slight movement of the cotton.
So there was a slight movement of the cotton.
And then he knew he was in samadhi, he was still alive.
So he knew that he was in samadhi and he was still alive.
At that time, Lord Nityananda and the others arrived.
At that time, Lord Nityananda and others arrived.
So they said they knew how to bring Lord Chaitanya back to consciousness.
And they said they knew how to bring Lord Chaitanya back to consciousness.
And they started to chant Hare Krishna.
And they started to chant Hare Krishna.
And then Lord Chaitanya came into his external consciousness.
And then Lord Chaitanya came into his external consciousness.
And Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya is the incarnation of Brihaspati.
So Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya is the incarnation of Brihaspati,
the guru of the Devas.
The guru of the Devas.
So he came down specifically to teach Lord Chaitanya.
So he came down specifically to teach Lord Chaitanya.
He was born in Navadvip Dham.
He was born in Navadvip Dham.
In Vidyanagar.
In Vidyanagar.
But somehow he became influenced by the Shankaracharya philosophy.
But somehow he became influenced by the Shankaracharya philosophy.
And he shifted to Jagannath Puri.
And he shifted to Jagannath Puri.
And there he became the chief pandit of the Shankara school.
There he became the chief pandit of the Shankara school.
And many sannyasis of the Shankara school took instructions from him.
Many sannyasis of the Shankara school took instructions from him.
So he wanted to teach Lord Chaitanya.
So he wanted to teach Lord Chaitanya.
Lord Chaitanya agreed that he would come back and take lessons from him.
So Lord Chaitanya agreed that he would come back and take lessons from him.
So and then Lord Chaitanya, he came back to hear from Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya.
And then Lord Chaitanya, he came back to hear from Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya.
But many days passed, he didn't ask any question.
But many days passed, he didn't ask any question.
Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya said, you're not asking any question.
Then Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya said, you are not asking any question.
You don't understand what I'm saying.
You don't understand what I am saying?
Lord Chaitanya said, well, I understand the verses of the Vedanta Sutra.
Lord Chaitanya said, well, I can understand the verses of the Vedanta Sutra.
But I don't understand your explanation.
But I don't understand your explanation.
So, normally the explanation is supposed to make the sutras easier to understand.
Normally, the explanations are supposed to make the sutras more easier.
Easier to understand.
Easier to understand the sutras.
He said he would understand the sutras, but not the explanation.
He said he understand the sutras, but not the explanation.
So, that means that he knew more than Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya.
So that means that he?
No more.
No more than Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya.
And then Lord Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya asked him to explain something.
So Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya asked him to explain.
So Lord Chaitanya explained the verse of Bhagavatama, the Atmarama verse.
Then Lord Chaitanya explained the verse from the Srimad Bhagavatam, the Atmarama verse.
And then he explained it in so many different ways.
And he explained it in so many different ways.
And he amazed Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya.
And he amazed Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya.
Then Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya asked him to reveal who he really was.
And then Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya asked him to reveal who he really was.
And then he revealed his identity as Radha and Krishna.
And then he revealed his identity as Radha and Krishna.
Or his Sarvabhauma Chaitanya.
Or his Sadbhuj Chaitanya form.
And so Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya became a devotee of Lord Chaitanya.
So Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya became a devotee of Lord Chaitanya.
And his devotion was unexpected in the Puri Kshetra.
And his devotion was unexpected in the Puri Kshetra.
But he would dance in kirtan, he would participate with Lord Chaitanya's Sankirtan party.
That he would dance in the kirtan, he would participate in Lord Chaitanya's Sankirtan party.
So, at that time, Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya had a tunnel which led directly to the Jagannath Puri Temple.
At that time, Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya had a tunnel which led directly to the Jagannath Puri Temple.
At the present time, there seemed to be a pond called Sweta Ganga.
At present time, there is a pond called Sweta Ganga.
I don't know if the tunnel works anymore.
I don't know if the tunnel works anymore.
Maybe this Sweta Ganga can be explained by someone else.
So maybe the Sweta Ganga can be explained by someone else.
But in this temple of Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, there's still deities about Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya.
In the temple of Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, there is still a deity of Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya.
And on the wall, there's a painting what Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya saw.
So, in the wall, there is a painting of what Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya saw.
So, like this, there's so many pastimes that occurred in Jagannath Puri.
So, like this, there were so many pastimes which occurred in Jagannath Puri.
So, he would be blessed by taking part in this parikrama.
So, you can be blessed by taking part in this parikrama.
Around Jagannath Puri.
Around Jagannath Puri.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hari Naam Param Nayane Shatatam Pranayashrudharam Pranamami Sachi Suta Gauravaram Pranamami Sachi Suta Gauravaram Pranamami Sachi Suta Gauravaram. Satatam janata bhava tapaharam paramartha parayana
লোক গতিং নবলে হকারং জগতাপহারং প্রণমামি সচিসুত গৌরবরং প্রণমামি সচিসুত গৌরবরং প্রণমামি সচিসুত গৌরবরং
হরে কৃষ্ণ 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 হরে 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 রাম হরে রাম 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 হরে হরে
হরে কৃষ্ণ হরে কৃষ্ণ 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 হরে 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 রাম হরে রাম 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 হরে হরে
হরে কৃষ্ণ হরে কৃষ্ণ 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 হরে 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 রাম হরে রাম